This is the iconic chair made by Urkel. We bought over 160 of these from the Haberdasher's School. This one is suffering from more or less every single problem in the book. It has got a split seat, it's got loose legs, it's got broken stretchers. There are lots of problems on this chair, but it is worth repairing. It's definitely for the more serious DIYer, but really it's something that happens to nearly all chairs. So once you've learnt the process, you can take it from this chair to the next one. So Drew's got this chair, which has got the very common problem of being a little bit wobbly. And what I'm going to try and do is show you how to glue up your own chairs at home, get these joints nice and cleaned up, glued up properly so that they last many, many years. So the first thing we need to do is get it knocked apart. Use a rubber mallet, because you're less likely to damage the seat at any point. So then we just gently knock it apart, a little bit at a time, one corner at a time. This broken stretcher is a very clean break, which means it will glue up really well as long as we set it properly. So we're going to use a quick drying polyurethane glue, which is very strong, and it's always important to use a decent adhesive. And I'm always keen to put plenty of glue on. It's better to wipe off excess than not have enough on the joint. You should see the glue squeeze out when you close the joint up. We need to let this set now for about 10 minutes, and then we can clean off the tops of the legs and fit the seat back on. We're ready to glue the seat on now, so we'll just take a bit of sandpaper to the top of the legs just to rough up the surface of the timber, because what we don't want is old glue gluing to timber. What we need is timber to timber surface. That's where we get our strength from. So remember again, it's important to use plenty of glue. Personally, I don't think you can use too much. We'll use our rubber mallet to bash it back into place. Now we've got that back into position, we can address this crack down the centre now. So what we're going to do, we're going to squeeze some glue in, and we're going to use a long clamp to pull that together so all those joints set at the same time. And we take our clamp, get it into place, so then we use some softwood blocks so that as we pull the clamp really tight, it doesn't damage the timber seat. And then before the glue's set, the final stage is to reattach the screws. So what we're going to do now, give that half an hour to set. Once it's dried, we can peel off the excess glue and it's ready to use again. When cleaning off the glue, just be gentle that you don't scratch the surface of the chair. Although we're going to be repolishing it, doesn't mean we need to put a gouge in it by being careless. So just be very gentle, take your time, and just sort of flake the glue off the surface. So now we've got all the glue off, we're just going to tidy up this worst of the repairs with a bit of sandpaper, just to make sure we've got no edges left on before we do the polishing. Solid as a rock.